Come on in, everybody. It is Tuesday, and it's time to talk. Good evening. Good evening, everybody. Good evening. I see you chiming on. I need you to tag and share. You know the routine. Come on, let somebody know that we're getting ready to have a little discussion. So make sure they like this post. Make sure you share this post. And make sure you tag someone and let them know that we are here. So come on in. Let's talk about it for a little while. This is Tuesday Talk. This is Tuesday Talk. So come on in. I see you chiming in. Thank you so much for tagging. Thank you so very much for tagging. Thank you so much for tagging. You know, we're not going to delay the time, and we're not going to talk a whole long time if y'all let me. But we're going to get this party started. So good evening, everybody. As you are chiming in, we welcome you to Tuesday Talks, a time when we just kind of talk through some things that, you know, kind of that all of us deal with from time to time. And so today's topic is don't be ashamed of your scars. Don't be ashamed of your scars. Psalms 139, I'll start there. Psalms 139 says, I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. But if the truth be told, y'all, we don't always feel wonderful. We don't always feel, you know, like we are well put together, you know, as we would desire to. We don't always like how we're made, you know, let the truth be told. Now, some people are very, you know, secure in themselves and they're confident in themselves, but everybody's not. You know, no matter how attractive somebody else may view us, sometimes we don't always see ourselves as that. And so there are a lot of things about ourselves that we don't like. And I could just talk, you know, about me. I could talk to the ladies about, you know, us. The brothers may have a different perspective as to how you look at various things concerning men. But like for most ladies, some of us, you know, we don't like our wide hips, or we don't like our wide nose. You know, we don't like our thick ankles. You know, we don't, there's a whole lot of stuff that we don't like about ourselves. You know, we have a list of stuff. If we could possibly change, we just might change it, you know. And then there are people on the other side of the spectrum that'll say, well, I wish I had that, and I wish I had that. And that just goes to prove, no matter who you are, whether you are tall, short, skinny, fluffy, whatever you want to call it, you don't always like some things about you, you know. Over the years, I've acquired quite a few scars, you know, and that's from falling down as a child, having skint up knees. And I said skint up, you know, having skint up knees. Some of it is from having various surgeries over the years, you know, where not skint up, but cut up, literally. So normally we hide our scars because our scars remind us of pain. You know, our scars remind us when we were hurt. Our scars remind us, you know, that we were cut at some point. Our scars remind us that we were wounded at some point in our lives. And most times there are some scars that we really would rather forget. And so we tend to hide, you know, behind our scarves, or we will disguise our scarves, or, you know, we make sure that they are covered up. We make sure that they are not exposed to the world, so to speak. And what we fail to realize is that when we hide and tuck away, you know, we are really minimizing or decreasing our own value. Let me slow down and say that again. Whenever we hide away, or whenever we tuck and hide, we decrease or we minimize our own value. We are failing to appreciate the worth or the value of our worth. And that's kind of the very kind of first point I want to make. We have to learn how to appreciate our value. We have to learn how to appreciate our value. You know, we are failing to appreciate all that God has made us. And he made us just as we are. No, he didn't tell us to eat the stuff we ate to make us the size that we are. But God predestined, and he knew, you know, how our journey would go. And he structured our body frames. He said we are fearfully and wonderfully made. And we have to always remember that in our understanding, because we've been taught, you know, that whenever something is flawed, it decreases in value. We've always known whenever something is flawed, it is decreased or it depreciates, yeah, if you will, in value. When there is a scratch on a brand new car, you know, it depreciates before it even gets off of the car lot. You know, if there is a flaw in your jewelry, ladies who know anything about diamonds, the first thing they want to tell you is how many flaws are in it. And it depreciates in value. In other words, it loses its value. And what happens is that we take what the world has said about appreciation and depreciation, and we have applied it to our own lives. But we should never, ever overlook the fact, no matter how many flaws we have, no matter how many scars or scratches that we have, that we have been fearfully and wonderfully made. We cannot forget that everything God made, he looked at it and he called it good. And no matter how you may feel about you, God called you good. No matter how flawed you are, and I'm getting excited about that. No matter how flawed you are, God looks at you and calls you good. And sometimes you need to remind your children of that. Sometimes you need to remind coworkers of that. No matter how bad things have been, no matter how tough the struggle has been, God looked at them and called them good. And so at some point in all of our lives, we have to learn how to appreciate all that we are, just the way we are, flaws and all. Now, can we make some things better? Can we brush up on some areas? Can we tighten up on some areas? Can we clean up some areas? Absolutely so. But just as you are who you are just who God wants for you to be, flaws and all. And don't get it twisted. Everybody got flaws. Everybody has flaws. The thing is, some of us cover them up better than others. Yeah, some of us cover up a little bit better than others do. I was just actually said this to somebody a couple of days ago, and we were talking about that, you know, the weight loss journey and, you know, walking and cutting back on eating and things of that nature. And someone said to me, well, you carry yours well. You know, I said, no, I hide it well. You know, yeah, my weight carries things, you know, but I hide it very, very well, you know, because we tend to hide things that we don't really have an appreciation for. Come on, I need you to hear me here. We tend to camouflage. We tend to keep undercover the things that we don't really have an appreciation for. And so, but the thing about it is, once the clothes come off, once the camouflage comes down, you still got to deal with what's up under there. Yeah, once the makeup comes off, once the bandages come off, what remains is your scarred reality. I said, what remains is your scarred reality. And no matter how you try to cover it, no matter how you try to make it look like something, what remains is your scarred reality. But here's the thing. Even though it is a part of your reality, you still have to be able to see the value in it. You still have to be able to see how it adds value to your life. Amen. And you see, I have to say that because if we don't handle our scars correctly, there will be some days when you won't even feel healed. That was good to me. I said, if we don't handle our scars correctly, there will be a lot of days when you don't even feel healed, and you will have no appreciation for what they represent. Are you hearing me here? You know, you. So we have to learn, as crazy as it sounds, to appreciate the scars. Come on, I need you to type that there in your timeline. You have to learn how to appreciate the scars and all that they represent. Please understand that every wound and every scar is a necessary part of your journey. They tell your story. There are some stories that you cannot really fathom on telling someone, but if they would just follow the scars, those scars tell your story. For those of you who have had to give birth via cesarean section, and there is a particular scar that's right there in that private area there. Lord have mercy. And you have to understand that that may not be the most attractive part of your body, but it is a beautiful testimony that you were gifted to be able to give the gift of life. It is a beautiful testimony that God trusted you enough to bring forth new life. And although it's a scar, and although it's not something that you would prefer to show off to the public or to the crowd, that scar represents the gift of life. You have to be able to learn to appreciate your scars. Amen. I'm one that has always been, you know, not so much proud of my scars. I don't want to use the word ashamed of them, but I haven't always wanted to display them. I have not always wanted to broadcast them. You know, I didn't want anyone to see them because I thought they made me look unattractive. You know, because you look at the magazines and you look at people who seemingly have perfect skin, or you look at people, let's be honest, that have perfect feet, or you see people, ladies in these bikinis, and they seem to have the perfect navel and the perfect stomach. I know the brothers don't want to hear nothing like that, you know, but us ladies look at stuff like that, you know. And so I never wanted anyone to see my scars because I deemed them as being unattractive. But one day something clicked in me, and the Holy Ghost allowed me to understand and to see that my scars were part of my message and my ministry. They had a message all by themselves. They had a ministry attached to them, because at the end of the day, as I said, your scars tell your story. And when I think about the a lot of the things that I went through to get those scars, it is a testimony that I survived the cut, I survived the bruise, I survived the wound, I survived the very thing that possibly could have taken me out of here. And so when I think about my scars and I look at my scars even today, it is a constant reminder that God loved me so much that he thought me worthy enough to bring me through that season. Come on, I need somebody to understand. Amen. You can look at your scars right now that you have on your body, and your scars are a daily reminder that you survived. They are a constant, beautiful reminder that you survive. I think about the time that I had to have surgery on my cervical spine. And in order to get to that portion of my spine, they literally had to cut my throat. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. They literally had to cut my throat. They had to go in and push my esophagus to the side. They had to manipulate my vocal cords and move them to the side in order to get to my spine and attach a plate and two metal screws together, put the vocal cords back in place, put the esophagus back in place, and literally sew my neck up. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. And what remains from that is a small scar right here that reminds me that that manipulation didn't work. Come on, that the cutting didn't work. Amen. And anything that the enemy would have tried to do to silence me in the midst of it all, it didn't work. Amen. Because there was a fear that I would not be able to sing again. There was a fear that my vocal cords would not get back into place where I could preach without getting too hoarse. And I am a living witness that none of that worked, because my voice is stronger than ever. And I realize that my voice has been ordained to be a blessing to so many others. And so that is just clear indication to me that whatever God has for you, it is for you. And there's nothing that the devil in hell can do about it. But at the end of the day, I got a scar there to remind me that I survived. Somebody, you got a scar somewhere on your body that reminds you that you survived. Now, it's one thing to be scarred physically, but it's another thing to be scarred emotionally and mentally. And a lot of times when we are scarred emotionally and mentally, we tend to stroke those wounds. We tend to get depressed over those wounds. We tend to cry about those wounds. And people are seeing them through our actions and through our reactions. But even in that, your reaction and your cries and your moans need to turn into praises. It needs to be an indication that you don't look like nothing that you've been through. Amen, somebody. Amen. I'm telling you, I got a few scars from a few procedures and a few circumstances and in events in my life. And I know there's a lot of people on this line that can say the same. I think about the scars on my feet, because I had surgery on both of my feet. And few of you that are here that from Emmanuel, you can remember, I had to submit to the surgery on both of my feet, and I had to submit, to the process of the healing. And when the healing was over, I was still left with two scars on my feet. And at first I would buy shoes that would hide the scar. I would buy, summertime came and I dreaded it. So I had to find sandals that would hide the scars. I would have to find shoes that would cover it just so. And then one day I looked and I remember the word of the Lord said, how beautiful are the feet of those who carry the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I had to get excited about the fact that I'm still able to stand boldly and proclaim the word of the Lord. I'm still able to shout and give God praise for the victory over the tricks and the traps and the works of the enemy. Listen, you've got to find a reason to find the value in your scars, whether they be physical scars, whether they be mental scars, whether they be emotional scars. You've got to find a reason to appreciate the value of them. When you think about scars, you can't help but think about the scars that Jesus Christ bore on his body. He bore scars in his hands. He bore scars in his feet. He bore scars from being pierced in his side. But those scars became a testimony to show everybody that he survived death, hell, and the grave. What do your scars show? Come on. What kind of testimony do your scars show? Amen. Those scars were proof for Jesus that he went to hell and back, and hell could not defeat nor hinder his destiny. And for somebody that's listening to my voice right now, you have been to hell and back, but hell could not even destroy or hinder or stop God's destiny for you. Lord have mercy. All I want you to know today is that you don't have to be ashamed of your scars. Your scars are a testimony that you survived. Amen. They are a testimony that the car wreck didn't kill you. They are a testimony that the manipulations did not work. They are a testimony that the poisons were not poisonous enough. Come on here. They are to remind you that you came out on the other side with victory. Those scars are there to remind you that your past could not destroy your future. The drama and the stabs in the back did not take you out of here. Even though you're still probably a little bit scarred from it, you don't look like what you've been through. Lord have mercy. And in spite of what it looks like to the natural eye, you are still victorious and you still hold value. Amen. Some of you on here right now, you have victory, but you're still nursing the scars of your past. You are victorious, but you're still nursing the scars of your past. Your scars, though, are proof that you survived. I said they are proof that you survived. And I want you to know, people of God, that you are valuable in spite of what it looks like to the outside. You are valuable and you have to know your worth. Come on, tell somebody down your timeline. You simply have to know your worth. And so the mere fact that you were scarred mentally, emotionally, and spiritually says to me that you are valued, that you are valuable to God, because the enemy is not going to try to destroy or diminish anything that does not have any value. The enemy is not going to try to depreciate anything that does not have any appreciated value. And so you have to understand that God has made you valuable in the kingdom. You just have to be able to embrace what you've had to go through to get this place, get to this place in the kingdom. Yeah. And he's giving you a voice to give him praise for it. Amen. So don't be afraid of your scars. It's just a sign. It's just evidence that you are victorious. It's just a sign of victory. Amen. It's a sign that you survive. It's a sign that you are valuable. Amen. That's my Tuesday talk for today. I just wanted to remind you how valuable you are. I just wanted to remind you, in spite of your scars, God still finds you fearfully and wonderfully made. In spite of your scars, you're still good. He's made you good. And you have to learn how to embrace all that you are, scars and all. Amen. I just wanted to encourage you, because somebody needed to be reminded just how valuable you are. And I want you, when you see your scars, as you are preparing, you know, to turn in for the night, and you see those scars and you see those scratches, I just want you to remember that's living proof that I survived. This is a scar. That's living proof that I made it out on the other side. It's living proof that the enemy even sees value in me. Because if he didn't see value in me, he wouldn't keep scratching at me like this. That's all. I just wanted to encourage somebody. This has been my Tuesday talk, and I appreciate you all so much for just being on board. I appreciate the Lord for each and every one of you for just taking time out of your schedule. As I said before, yes, that's right, Monica, battle scars. As I always say, these Tuesdays are not meant to be anything long and drawn out, but just a little nugget, just to encourage and just to empower you. For those of you that have not yet, I want you to please go and check out my podcast. It's free, either on Apple Pod or on Spotify. Make sure you go and check it out. Those are just 3 and 4 minute words of encouragement, you know, a few words of empowerment. Sometimes people don't do the whole church thing. Sometimes they don't want to read a whole lot of scripture. Sometimes they just need a little push. And so, you know, tell somebody on your job, you know, if you into podcasts, check out my pastor's podcast, and I promise you they'll be blessed. It's my desire to add a couple each week. There are only maybe 4 or 5 out there right now, but each week I'll add, you know, a couple more just to continue to increase it. But I pray that you've been blessed by this word on tonight. If you are led to sow into this ministry, you can do so at Cash App, KMM 707. If you're led to sow into this word tonight, you can do so at KMM 707. And for those of you that prefer PayPal, you can do so at KM Ministry. But I pray that you have been blessed in some shape, form, or fashion. Again, thank you so much for joining me on tonight. Don't forget, we are having Bible study for Emmanuel tomorrow night at 7:30. And so we invite you to come and be our guest on tomorrow night for our Bible study. I thank you so much for joining us. Please make sure you go and connect with us on at Kimberly Moore Ministries. Make sure you connect with me on Instagram as well as on YouTube, because we want you to make sure you stay connected with all that we're trying to accomplish in the kingdom. Amen. Amen. Monica says this word made me want to run on. All right, Monica, run on, girl, and see what the end is going to be. You ain't got them scars for nothing. I promise you. I promise you. They add value to your life. They add value to your life. All right, my brothers and my sisters, I saw a couple of brothers on here earlier today. And so I say good evening to you all as well. But I so again appreciate each and every one of you. So join me back here again for another Tuesday talk at another on another Tuesday. And I promise I'll do my best to bring forth the encouragement that you may need for that particular day. All right. This has been Dr. Kimberly Moore with Tuesday Talks. And I'm so thankful that you tuned in today. God bless you all. Have an amazing evening and know that I love you all with the love of the Lord. Have a good one.